There's a line in T.S. Eliot's fourth quartet, at the still point of the turning world, there the dance is.
She loves her craft, dance so passionately. I think every moment that she's alive, she is being the dancer.
To each other, give the moon away now, yes.
I feel that Mary stands as a very strong example of what it is for an artist to hold a fort, to be courageous with her tenacity, her grit.
Mary teaches us to dance in life.
She was like a magnet, like a Pied Piper. Wonderful people always came to Mary.
My first teacher, who introduced me to dance, said to me, if you want to train and have the best training, you must go to New York, you must go to Juilliard, and you must study with Mary Anthony.
One, two, ready, and go, and one. Two. Three. To the back. 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 Dancing was the first thing that man did. He danced before he spoke. A dancer is total. Back. They are the instrument. A painter has a canvas, a pianist has a piano, but you are your instrument.
One image when I was taking class with Mary, and she was showing us how to go on a diagonal across the floor, and she was like the wind. It was so fascinating to watch her skitter across that floor and then hit the other side, and I always thought that was the essential quality in her personality and in her dancing, a kind of wingedness.
She reminds me of Ariel in The Tempest. There's something not earthbound about her.
Mary was very striking and was one of the most theatrical, dramatic dances I had ever seen.
I feel that art chooses you. You don't choose art. And I feel that even more true in dance. When I was in this little town of Newport, Kentucky, at the age of two, at Christmas time, where all my cousins were ripping their presents open and trying to see what they had gotten for Christmas, the word is that I was dancing around the Christmas tree, and I was not interested in my presents. And I know that even then, way back then, I must have begun to choreograph, because I would make my cousins come dancing through a French door, and I'd say, you come through that door, you be on your knees here, you do this, you do that. So as far back as that time, which was when I was about 5 or 6 years old, I was already beginning to choreograph.
Stop. Tom.
Yeah, then it twists, but it doesn't.
Yeah, there we go. Well, see, it has to be like that all the way across the stage.
Early on, while I was going with a playwright, I had read Riders to the Sea and loved it as a play and said I wanted to do it as a dance one day. And the playwright said, you can't touch that. It's a perfect one-act play. But it stayed in my mind. It really stayed in my mind. And that I knew that one day I would do it. In the 50s, was it Bennington, that I created Fernetti. I would teach in the afternoon, but every morning I had a studio all to myself. No phones, no interruptions, no nothing. So the Threnody went together more quickly than almost any of the pieces I've ever done, simply because I had the time and the peace to do it.
It came out of her almost as an act of grace. It was as if she had done her inner work for it, and it just came. And I think we knew from the beginning that this was going to be a very exceptional piece of work.
It was about myself. It was about loss. The play is about this old woman who has lost her sons.
I was moved as her portrayal of a mother losing her son. It was just a basic human condition.
Of that work. If she never did another thing, that work would stand as a monumental dance.
Louis Horst said it was one of the most beautiful things and most realized performances in choreographic work that he had ever seen.
In playing the character of the old woman who is the mother, to get the key to how was she going to move in the last part, which is the threnody, I walked around my studio saying out loud all of her final speeches. And the final one, one of the final ones, was where she looked out and said, they're all gone now. There is nothing more the sea can do to me.
There was a kind of humanity and inner outer strength and radiance that was extraordinary when she created the part of the mother in Threnody, her emblematic work.
Breathing in one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, open the world. Take it inside yourself. And then to your center. I feel that the artists are the editors of the world. Give it away. Long after the centuries passed, it will be the works of art that will tell people what we were. Okay. And open. Dance is a way of life, And when I opened my first studio on 4th Avenue, it was to be a place where people could find their physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual center.
And one, two, stretch to the left. Two, five, five. Two, two, five, five.
She gives you a sense of your own worth by encouraging that, nurturing that being that's within you. Push her down here, she's gonna come up someplace else.
And close. Good.
But when I first got here, she would tell this story about people who were wondering if they should be dancers. And she kept saying that if you were wondering, like, you wouldn't be. Like, the answer was that you had to be a dancer.
She's a survivor.
She's been through so many vicissitudes and hardships, and like all of us, but somehow she's managed to find an inner resource, an inner storage of what I call light, of radiance, which is manifested through her work, through her teaching, and it's a kind of love of life, actually. It transcends so many of the mundane things that we're all concerned with. She's able to transcend that.
If this were Japan, Mary would be one of those people who would be accorded the National Living Treasure title, of course, because of longevity, as well as talent, and because of where she's come from and what she's gone through, because of the work she's contributed, because of the many people she's taught, because of the fact that she's now in her 80s and still working and still inspiring people.
There's something so wonderful about being in a studio and hearing a piece of music that inspires you and then letting your body express what you were feeling to that music. Important thing for me there was that I had created a new work at 80. Kun Young and Mary Ford were so sympathetic to the way we were working, which was new for me. I couldn't, but I could say to them, can you take the theme on the floor? Can you evolve the theme? Can you two do it simultaneously? Can you do it in opposition? And they were like Ross and Yuriko had been in the past. They were so sensitive that it came like that with their help. One of my favorite sayings, which I use as a key for me. It's an old Chinese proverb. Learn as though you're going to live forever. Live as though you might die tomorrow. Thank you, class. That's a good question. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.